What is up, everybody? Dan Becker here. Welcome back to the channel. I'm into hiking and backpacking and gear. If you guys are into that stuff too, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I'm in beautiful La Crosse, Wisconsin right now, camping with my family. I'm on my 8th day straight camping right now. And I've got, I think, 2 more to go. The first 3 were backpacking. I did 34 miles in 48 hours, so all of you people that say I don't hike a lot of miles, you should be proud of me, because I really don't hike a lot of miles. But that was a high mileage trip in a short amount of time for me. But before we get too far, check out this tree. Look at that. Isn't that wild? Just blew over in the wind. I don't know when it did that. It must not have been too long ago, because the leaves are still green. We're gonna talk about expensive versus inexpensive backpacks, and we're also gonna talk about features that I think you really should be looking for in a backpack. Also, before I get too far, I wanna thank the sponsor of today's video, Backcountry. Backcountry, thank you for sponsoring the video. If you're here and you're like, man, I'm just gonna buy my backpack now, that's the first thing I need to buy, don't do that. Go out and buy a couple other things first. Buy your shelter first, then buy your sleep system, and then buy your backpack. Why do you wanna do that? Well, you wanna make sure that those things are going to fit inside of your backpack. So if you buy your backpack first, it may not be the right size and may not fit all of that other gear. So go buy that other stuff first. Also, don't chintz on those items. Don't chintz on any of your big 3 items, your backpack, your sleep system, and your shelter. Those are gonna be your most expensive and your heaviest gear, but it's also gonna bring the most comfort to your trip, and it's really gonna determine for you how well that trip's gonna end up being from a comfort standpoint for you. So you don't want to, man, I don't want to tell you to go out and spend a ton of money, but I don't want to tell you to underspend either. You want to make sure you get decent stuff. Let's talk about choosing the right size. So I already explained to you that, you need to buy those other gear items first, but let's say you've already got that kind of stuff and you're just, you know, wondering what size you're going to need because you're maybe thinking the length of your trip is going to be that determining factor, and it is a little bit of a determining factor for you. But for most trips, you're really just gonna take the same stuff you always would. You're gonna take pretty much the same sleeping bag, the same tent, the same, you know, gear items. What you're gonna have that's gonna be different is gonna be your food, your water, and your fuel. That is gonna be the biggest determining factor of gear that's gonna take up space inside of your backpack, because the longer you go, the more you're gonna take in food, and the more you're gonna take in fuel, and the more water you're gonna need, and that kind of thing. So I'll just say this, if you're new, you're probably gonna end up needing a backpack that's at least 60 to 70 liters. If you're an experienced backpacker, you're gonna get away with backpacks that are in the 30s as far as liters go, because you've got your gear dialed down. So for instance, this was like the 3rd or maybe the 4th backpack that I bought. This is the Osprey Exos 48. This one is actually my wife's, but I actually own this one in a blue model. This is a 48 liter backpack. And by then I had my gear dialed down pretty well. It's a backpack that has a frame to it. It's got a back mesh portion here that keeps it off of your back. So it's got ventilation and it's really lightweight. It's got hip belt pockets on here. It's got a brain on it. But then I decided I wanted to upgrade and I've got a Dyneema backpack. Here's an example for you of a Dyneema backpack. This is a Hyperlite Mountain Gear Southwest 2400. This particular backpack is a very, very well built but extremely lightweight backpack that carries a heavy load, and so that's why I chose this one. Or maybe you're like a super organized person and you want something with a lot of pockets and that kind of thing. That's fine. I don't like that because I tend to bring more gear when I have backpacks like that, and I tend to not be organized. As a matter of fact, it makes it worse for me because I can never remember which pocket I put something in. But this one would probably be a little bit more for you. This one does have a brain on it. That means that it's got this top portion similar to the Osprey Exos. It's a 60 liter backpack. It's also a roll top, but you've got a back pocket here, you got a pocket here, you got a pocket here for your water bottles. And then you also have hip belt pockets that are nice and big, so you can put inside like phones and other snacks and different items in there that would take up a lot of room. This backpack is the Granite Gear Crown 60. And in my personal opinion right now, this is probably the best budget backpack on the market. This is almost the perfect backpack for someone who's starting out, or if you just don't want to spend a lot of money on a great backpack. This backpack weighs just over 2 pounds, so it's extremely lightweight. And you can find this backpack right now at Backcountry for $150 as of the filming of this video. It retails for about $200, but I have a discount code. It's 15% off. The code is Dan15. Some exclusions do apply, but if it ends up being full price, you can apply that code and see if it works for you. It should get you down to about $170 for this backpack. It's 60 liters, which is huge for a backpack of that weight. It's got a back pad here that has sort of like a thin layer, I don't know if you can see that on here, almost like a screen material that does provide some decent ventilation. And then the hip belt here is resizable. So you could take this out and you can adjust it to come around or go back depending on how big your hips are. Your hips don't lie, do they? This is also a framed backpack. It's got a very flexible frame, but it distributes the weight really well. Also, let me just say this. If you are shopping for backpacks and you see this here, where it says like the size of the backpack on the backpack, just know that that's not your height. Like if you're a tall person, it doesn't necessarily mean that you're gonna get the long version, or if you're a short person that you should get the short version. That's a measurement of your torso. So that would be like from the middle of your back between your hip bones all the way up to this little bone up here, and I don't even know what it's called. Right here, if you bend your neck down, it kind of sticks out. The distance between there and there is the measurement on the backpack, so keep that in mind. My buddy Mark and I went backpacking and I gave him this backpack to use. I was like, hey Mark, I know you got some heavier gear and you've been looking for a new backpack. This backpack may be the backpack for you. By the end of the trip, we had hiked 34 miles and he loved this thing. So let's look at the differences. You've got a $350 backpack and you have a $200 backpack. What are you really getting from this backpack that you're missing out of this backpack? Well, in most situations, the higher the price, you're really getting less backpack. And what I mean by that is there's usually less features and it's more expensive materials to make the backpack lighter. It doesn't mean that this is a better backpack. It just means that this backpack may be for a more advanced user because it's a lower capacity and it's made out of a waterproof, lightweight material called Dyneema that is extremely lightweight. Whereas this backpack, it's not waterproof. However, it is very water resistant, but it's much bigger and it only weighs a little bit more. So where this backpack is about 1.5 pounds, this backpack weighs a little bit over 2 pounds, but you're gonna get 40 liters out of this pack and you're gonna get 60 liters out of this pack. So is this backpack worth $150 more? Well, in my situation, it is, because I backpack so often. This is a very durable, lightweight backpack for what I do, and it holds my gear effectively without having to be waterproofed. So I appreciate that fact about it, and it's extremely comfortable. But that doesn't mean I couldn't get away with this backpack either. This backpack will still hold about 35 pounds. This backpack will hold about 40 pounds. And if you've got a lot of gear, this backpack is gonna fit that gear a lot better than this backpack. So you could easily save yourself $200 right now and get this backpack over this backpack. And this, like I said, could be the best budget backpack on the market. I had to stand up again. My legs were falling asleep. Oh, that was brutal. Okay, some backpacks come with rain covers. And I remember when I was shopping for backpacks, that was like, oh, does the backpack come with a rain cover? What? It doesn't. I gotta buy that extra. Are you kidding me? Well, you don't really need a rain cover. What you can do is just get a garbage bag and pack all of your stuff you don't want to get wet, like your, you know, your sleeping bag and that kind of thing, inside the garbage bag and put that inside of your backpack. So you can keep things waterproof that way. It's pretty much free. A rain cover is convenient, but you know, they're like when you're hiking and stuff and you're really tired, the last thing you want to do is stop and pull out a rain cover. You just want your backpack to be waterproof. Also, full disclaimer, I have never used the Granite gear for an overnight backpacking trip. I have, however, day hiked with it fully loaded out, and I found that it was a very comfortable backpack. I am 6 feet 2, 210 pounds, and it fit me just perfectly. But you can get that in different sizes according to your torso. The Hyperlite Mountain Gear Southwest 3400 and 2400, I have both of those backpacks. Love them. If you've got the money to spend and you're ready to get into backpacking as like something you're gonna do often, I would highly recommend. This is my most recommended, favorite, best backpack I've ever used. That one right there, highly recommend it. It's just been a fantastic backpack overall. And you might be thinking, well, man, Dan, $150 or $200 for a backpack, that's like ridiculously expensive. I don't want to spend that on a backpack. I will just tell you, I've done a lot of research on backpacks, and that is not expensive for a backpack that is lightweight and going to be comfortable and do the job for you while you're out there. Can you find cheaper backpacks? Absolutely, you can find cheaper backpacks. But I've purchased cheaper backpacks, and I've found that in most situations, they not only do really poorly on trail because they're very uncomfortable and don't adjust well, but they are also backpacks that typically will fall apart just after a few uses. And that's from experience. I have bought very inexpensive backpacks, used them on overnight trips, and they were terrible. And they made the backpacking experience terrible. So a backpack can be one of the key items for your trip that will make or break that trip. Hopefully this video helps you guys out. If you guys like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Also, subscribe for more. Make sure you hit the bell notification so I can send you a video every time it's released. And I will see you on the next one.